Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's game features arguably the best defense in the NFL. The Redskins are top 10 in fewest points allowed, and they'll be up against the Rams offense that wants to prove it can do some damage. With that, let's hand it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. They've got the call in this Week 6 matchup.
We are just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Dome, as we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Today, we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here between the Los Angeles Rams and the Washington Redskins. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Carry here for Todd Gurley. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. The offense on your screen now, and Todd Gurley on your screen. That is the back of the present and the future.
And what an amazing return for him from a knee injury his last year in college at the University of Georgia. Now, it's like it never happened. There's nothing he can't do on the football field. If you're a defense, that's a long day trying to prepare for Todd Gurley.
And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield. A really nice pickup.
Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And on this first drive, looks like they want to get that vertical passing game going early.
And they did, and what a warning shot they just fired. If you're not going to back up and play coverage deep, we're going to attack you all game long. And once you adjust to that and you start to back off, then that opens things up underneath. A really nice start for them. Great way to get the game going.
And this is taken in at the 5. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line.
When I watched Jared Goff on tape at Cal, I saw a guy who wasn't just a dart thrower. You know, a lot of people said, he's perfect for the West Coast offense. I always thought he could do a little bit more, and that was the reason why. He can push it downfield. He has a good, strong arm.
On first and goal, Gurley. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. With their backs against the wall. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Call it a gain of 13 yards on the play. And that'll make it second and goal.
That's a good strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
They'll try and push it in with Gurley. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. And here is the Redskin defense.
Josh Norman was not a first-round pick when he entered the NFL, but he always thought he should be. Never lacked for confidence, and now he plays at a Pro Bowl level.
Third and goal, Gurley. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Todd Gurley, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Rams take it right down and score on the opening drive.
Thank you.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. They go play action here on first down. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll try to get forward, but he's going to be stopped in his tracks at about the 3. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Brandon, there's no doubt the defense has to be excited after stacking up back-to-back running plays. But I still remember my old coaches saying, after you've had some success, you better be careful. They might have an answer for you. So make sure you watch your keys, play your techniques, and don't get overconfident. Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time, spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
And taken right at the 35. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Rams will go on offense here with the first and 10. First down throw, gone. Gonna throw right side here, complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now on second down, this is Gurley. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding him to no gain.
The one running back is Gurley. Gone. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Let's go. Now a play fake here on first down. And he finds a man on a crossing route. A gain of 6 there on first. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend there?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other...
Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And the last drive, their first drive, 3 and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This one complete to Jordan Reed. 23 yards on the play. And there they they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
He'll drop to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Washington. Their big-bodied receiver. His second touchdown on the season. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Toss. It's Gurley. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, but they face a second and long to start things out. Stick to the ground game with Gurley. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12. Give him three on the play, and that'll bring up a third down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
On third down, they'll run it with Gurley. And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. Ball at a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. This is away, and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. Taken from just outside the 30. Can't ask for much more than that. A 50-yard punt followed by a loss on the return. And the Redskins will take possession with a first and 10.
Hey, hey, hey. Hey. Here we go now.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
So completion on second down, that brings up third. They come out here in the eye. Yeah, here's Marshall. Now after the punt on that play, we've got a man down on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. Fourth down. Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first.
have to tell you, this play call surprised me a bit here on fourth down. This isn't fourth and one. They need a few yards here. But the element of surprise to give it to the fullback, I think ultimately is what's going to get them the first down.
And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets. And linebackers are not easy ones to hit because they know how to move, juke, and make you miss. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A nice play for the defense.
They got pressure there and only rushing 3.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with 3 there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping 8. Where are you going to go with the football?
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third.
Let's go.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A play fake to Gurley. Now gone. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Goff turns and gives to Gurley. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
A good pickup there, a 22.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
From the 50, it's gone. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And a pretty simple completion there underneath, but a successful one for the offense.
Partner, doesn't have to be the big shots downfield all the time. Having that safety net underneath is a great thing for a quarterback.
They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff. He's got his man on the crossing route. A good pick up there of 20 yards. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they showed to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the 2-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the 2-minute signal.
Another carry now for Gurley. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. They'll fake the handoff. Now gone. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Their dangerous wide receiver. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Rams have taken the lead. And it's up and good. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Then confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. On first down, it's Gurley. Oh, what a move. Still on his feet. Cuts it out here. Touchdown, LA! Todd Gurley with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Rams add on to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Redskins offense now, they head back onto the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
All right, here we go. Back to the NFL. Here we go.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback because he had no chance to block him.
Hurry up, here we go. Bleed, over, over, over.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. A great, and he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you're bringing back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it, not just one tip, but multiple tips, just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski, okay? Oski was an interception.
For different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a
too many syllables. Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. And here come the Redskins now. Six, they go right nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Aaron Donald in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
He's going to let this one go deep. They were trying to get it there to Josh Doxon. Third down here.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Here's Tressway now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
All right, here we go.
On first and 10, Goff. He's going to air one out. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what?
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Defense looking to hold serve one last time here on third and 7. Now Goff will hand this one to Gurley. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. First down throw, gone. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and it'll make it a second down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This will approach NFL record territory. It's a 62-yard attempt. So that would have been something from that distance, but to no avail. Comes up empty as we have reached the intermission. As we send you down to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Larry. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is. Right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. This is a real, I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
Let's go!
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Gone, 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 gone.
The Rams go nickel here defensively on third. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll look to throw now on first down. Out to the left here to Reed. That throw good for 4. It's second down. Second down now after the pass completion.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation.
And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Aaron Donald in there to get him. And that's sack number 6 for him on the year. Out of the gun now on third down. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down.
All right, here we go. Leopard! Leopard! All right, now look at 56.
They're going to try and throw. It's brought in by Dachson. 19 yards there on the pickup. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And the last go-around for them, they tried that really, really long field goal, couldn't connect.
And in retrospect, I think a lot of people would say, well, why would you try one that long? You hurt yourself in field position, the ball comes out, you know, there. That only helps the other team. But I look at it as maybe it was a double shot of confidence. Confident the kicker could make it, and even if he missed, confident in their defense that they can hold him.
And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now Goff on first down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Second and 10, Goff. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A solid gain of 15 yards, and the sticks move. So the offense has it first and 10.
All right, now look at 56.
Now a first down throw, Goff. This will be caught at about the 3. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver, his second touchdown on the season. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Aaron Donald in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year.